Hi guys, welcome to the daily news analysis channel of the Hindu newspaper. Today we will have the discussion on the newspaper of 7th May 2015. As you can see the first page of the Hindu newspaper, on this page actually one image is important. News on this page, there is not a single news important for UPSC today on this page, so only one image is important. You can see the name of the image, on the move. This is very important image or the information given below, because this actually connects the geography sector of the UPSC, so this is important. Read the information given below of the news, because the place where the incidents occur, that the name of that place is very important. So please go through this image, very important. Now we'll move directly to the page number 7, because in between pages there is not a single news important for UPSC, so we will directly move to the page number 7. Here on the page number 7, I will read the headline of the important news. Return of child to place of habitual residence may not be in best interest. So this was the headline of the news. I will read the introduction. A committee set up by the center to prepare a report on the issue of inter-country parental child abjugation has questioned one of the basic principles of the Hague Convention by arguing that the return of the child to his or her habitual residence may not necessarily be in the best interest of the child. So this was the introduction of the news. Now I will tell you the important points. There is immense pressure on India from the US to accede to the Hague Convention on the civil aspects of international child abjugation, which is a multinational treaty that seeks to protect children wrongfully removed by one of the parents from the custody of the other parent. So the name of the treaty is important here, Hague Convention on the Civil Aspects of International Child Abjugation, which is a multinational treaty that seeks to protect children wrongfully removed by one of the parents from the custody of the other parent. The second important point of the news is the panel has also prepared a draft law to safeguard the interest of the children as well as those of parents, particularly mothers. So this was also the important point. The next important point is the important conditions under which a child return can be refused are, that is, they have given three important conditions. First of them is best interest of the child. The second important condition is domestic violence or mental or physical cruelty or harassment against the parent claiming the return of the child was not exercising the custody rights at the time of removal. The third important condition under which a child's return can be refused is if there is a grave risk that the child would be exposed to physical or psychological harm. So these were the three important conditions under which a child's return can be refused. The next important point is the report also requires the setting up an inter-country parental child removal disputes resolution authority, which will be the nodal body to decide on the custody of the child, mediate between the warring parties, as well as order the return of the child to the country of habitual residence. So these were the important points from this news. Now we'll move to the next news actually. Sorry, I will read the headline. Adult couple can live together, says Supreme Court. So this one is also important news actually. First two paragraphs from this news are really very important. An adult couple has a right to live together without marriage, the Supreme Court said, while asserting that a 20-year-old Kerala woman whose marriage had been annulled, could choose whom she wanted to live with. The top court held that live-in relationships were now even recognized by the legislature, and they had found a place under the provision of the Protection of Women from Domestic Violence Act 2005. So actually this is important. The live-in relationship were now even recognized by the legislature, and they had found a place under the provision of the Protection of Women from Domestic Violence Act 2005. So from this news only that much was important. We'll move to the next news. I will read the headline. Partial success for Gram Swaraj Abhiyan. That was the heading of the news. I will read the introduction. At the end of a 3-week drive to bring 7 flagship schemes to 16,850 villages with a high number of poor, scheduled castes and scheduled tribes households, less than 30% of target households received an electricity connection, while less than 40% got a gas connection, according to government data. So this news is actually related about Gram Swaraj Abhiyan scheme and its achievements. Now I will tell you the important points only. The first important point is the Gram Swaraj Abhiyan was launched by Prime Minister Narendra Modi on April 2014 on the birth anniversary of Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, to reach out to villages, most of which have a majority of Dalit and tribal homes. The objective of the program was to promote social harmony, spread awareness about pro-poor initiatives of government, reach out to poor households to enroll them in various welfare programs. So this was the first point, which is important actually from the news. Now the second important point is the Saubhagya scheme to give every household an electricity connection reached 4 lakh homes as against a target of 14.5 lakh homes. The target was actually 14.5 lakh and the schemes actually fulfilled for only 4 lakh homes. That is, only 27% of target has been achieved. The next point is, under the Ujwala scheme to give gas connections to all homes, 5.6 lakh households were reached out of total target of 14.4 lakh. Fourth, that is next important point is, the Pradhan Mantri Jeevan Jyoti Bima Yojana, a life insurance scheme, enrolled 73% of targeted beneficiaries. Next, Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bima Yojana, a risk insurance scheme for accidental death or disability, enrolled 88% targeted beneficiary. So this was actually important from the news. That information actually has been given in the image at the center of the news. So please go through this image, that is, go through this image, that is, they have given the name of the schemes, their target beneficiaries and actual achievement. So in the three columns they have provided very good information. So please go through this image. Now we'll move to the next page. Here on the page number 10, actually one news is important. A panel for revamp of Indo-Nepal treaty. I will read the introduction. The final report of bilateral committee appointed to advise governments in Delhi and Kathmandu is likely to suggest that 1950 India-Nepal Peace and Friendship Treaty should be revised. So actually from this news, this is very important, the 1950 India-Nepal Peace and Friendship Treaty. The news otherwise is not very much informative. I will tell you the 1950 India-Nepal Treaty of Peace and Friendship. What was that? Actually, the 1950 India-Nepal Treaty of Peace and Friendship is a bilateral treaty between Nepal and India, establishing a close strategic relationship between two neighbors, that is India and Nepal. The treaty was signed at Kathmandu on 31st of July 1950 by the last Rana Prime Ministers of Nepal, Mohan Shamsher Jung Bahadur Rana, and Indian Ambassador to Nepal, Chandreshwar Narayan Singh. It came into force the same day as per Article 9 of the treaty. Actually, the treaty allows free movement of people and goods between the two nations and a close relationship and collaboration on matters of defense and foreign policy. So, from this news, actually, the treaty they have mentioned, that treaty actually very important. And as I said, I have just introduced the treaty. If you want any detailed information about treaty, you can Google it. Okay, on this page only this news was important. We'll move to the next page, that is page number 12. Here on the page number 12 also, you can see one news in the upright corner. US will regret quitting deal. This is a statement given by Iran. I will read the introduction. Iranian President Hassan Rouhani said on Sunday that if the US quits the nuclear deal between Tehran and world powers, then Washington would regret it like never before. So this is very important news, because in this news they have mentioned Iran nuclear deal framework of 2015. So that is only important, like earlier news. I will tell you only what was the Iran nuclear deal framework of 2015. Actually, the Iran nuclear deal framework was a preliminary framework agreement of 2015 between Islamic Republic of Iran and the countries, that is the United States, the United Kingdom, Russia, France, China and Germany. According to this framework, actually, Iran would redesign, convert and reduce its nuclear facilities and accept the additional protocol in order to lift all nuclear related economic sanctions, freeing up tens of billions of dollars in oil revenue and frozen assets. So this was actually important. From this news, the Iran nuclear deal framework of 2015, which was actually important. If you will go through this news, only one actually paragraph is important. The nuclear deal was struck in 2015 between Iran and Britain, China, France, Germany, Russia and the US. So only from this news that paragraph was important, but actually important was what? The Iran nuclear deal framework of 2015. Now we'll move to the next page, that is page number 13. Here on the page number 13, I will read the headline of the news. Review Insolvency Code Regulations, NCLT, that is National Company Law Tribunal, tells Bankruptcy Board. News is very important. I want all of you to go through this news. The whole news actually important. And the same way, on the next page, that is page number 14, there is also one news. Rupee is dancing to more tunes this year. Actually, this is also very, very, very important news, and it is very difficult to cover the whole news. It will take a whole session. So I want all of you to go through this and read the whole news on your own, because it is very important news and very informative. It is important to make your own perspective about the news, which will help you in your mains examination or mains answer writing of UPSC examination. So on this page only this much, and for today also this much was necessary. On the sports news today also, there is not a single news important. Don't waste your time looking at the sports pages. Now thanks, that much is all right for today. Thank you. If you are liking, please like and subscribe. Thank you.